Hello, everyone. It has been quite some time since I LP'd anything on a PlayStation 2. I think the last time I LP'd or streamed anything on PS2 was Resident Evil 4, and that was some time ago. But, why'd I whip this thing out? Well, if your childhood was anything like mine, you'll be seeing here in just a moment. Something special made me bring out my PS2 again. Yep. We're starting Simpsons Hit and Run today, and boy, oh boy, am I excited to play this one. I can't even remember the last time I've been so excited to start an LP. Real quick, I gotta grab my remote. Alright, there. I just turned up my TV a little bit. Hopefully it won't cause echo into the microphone. If it does, I'll turn it down for next time. What can I say about this? When I bought this as a child, oh my lord, I played the hell out of this. Where, like, I did everything.
Radical.
Yes, Radical Entertainment, this is your claim to fame. So, this is the best Simpsons game ever made. I don't think anyone would argue this. Even trolls don't really try to refute this. Let's start the game with a cutscene. That wasp had a real bad day. Oh, and, yeah, I forgot. The menu here changes if you have the time set to a holiday, which technically it's still Halloween, according to my PS2. So what can we do here? Bonus game? Well, I can't do nothing with this.
You know where my family lives.
Load game, I can't do anything with that, because I erased the data I had on my memory card. So, let's jump right into this, shall we?
Hey, hey! I'm endorsing a new cola, kids! And this one isn't poisonous to anybody!
That we know of.
New and improved Buzz Cola is made from only the finest sugars and waters. Plus, it has a special ingredient, too hot for the FDA. It'll give you the get-up-and-go you need to do all the pathetic stuff you have to do. Try new improved Buzz Cola.
Cola. Must get Buzz Cola.
Local man ruins hot dog eating contest. Disqualified for vomiting. That would happen. 90% of video games start with easy tutorial level. I'm not going to explain how to play the game. I'm not going to tell you the controls or any of that. And there's a very good reason.
All right, player one, Homer. Use a directional button or left analog stick to move around. This is called walking. Press the X button to jump and hold down the circle button to run. Anytime you're in the air, hit jump again to get a little extra push. Got it?
Ah, we'll let Bart do the explaining for us. Talk to Marge. What if I don't want to talk to Marge yet? What if I want to go over here?
Main like shiny thing.
Yeah, great. Those shiny things are called coins. Whenever you get enough of those, you can get a cool surprise.
It was all I could do to contain myself during that. Because, again, I'm so giddy and excited to be playing this. So, hey, what's that thing up there? What's this?
There are a bunch of these scattered in each level. Little surprises are hidden inside each one. Be sure to come back again to see if there's something you missed.
Oh, that was from... Actually, that was from quite a few episodes. Here we have this tiki head thing. I forget what episode that was from specifically, though I do remember it. Swing set. Homer, get up on the platform. You'll have to excuse the graphics. This is PS2 graphics being upscaled, so yeah, some of the graphics don't exactly look great, though it still looks fine, and...
There's some collector cards hidden all over Springfield. Find the other ones, and sweet reward is yours for the taking. If you want to take a closer look at the cards, you can see them in the pause menu. And don't get your stinky fingers on them, fatty.
How dare you? Ah, the homemade football from... I forget what episode it was called. Let's look at it, shall we? Homer at bat.
Yeah, I got a magic bat, too.
And I got an enchanted jock strap. Yeah, the ups. Yeah. So this game is very referential of the past, which.
Press the triangle button to thank get God. In the car. Don't take all day. This is the tutorial.
At least it actually tries to have throwbacks to The Simpsons. Also, if this is too bright, let me know in the comments.
Homie, somebody ate every dessert in the house. I need you to run to the store and pick up some of that ice cream with the miniature pies in it.
Oh, must have been one of our kids. Probably Milhouse.
Yeah, Milhouse is one of your kids, Homer. Alright, so Cola Caper. This is the easy tutorial level. By easy, I mean it's literally impossible to fail.
Okay, homeboy, here's how you drive this crap box. Press the X button to accelerate and use the left analog stick or directional button to steer. The circle button is your brake in reverse, and the square button is your handbrake. You know, just like every driving game ever.
Yes, if anyone's ever played a Grand Theft Auto, cough, cough, you should know how to play this.
Way to go, Homer, you the man! Collecting wrenches fixes your car.
Cool deal.
That's the stuff, psycho! And so it begins.
Indeed, Bart, indeed. So yeah, break objects and blow up cars to get coins. Use coins to buy stuff. Let's just plow into that. I'm supposed to go to the Quickie Mart. Can I enter the Quickie Mart? How do I do that?
You can go inside certain buildings by pressing the triangle button. Ugh, why did I agree to do this stupid tutorial? It is so boring.
That's a good question, Bart. Why did you agree to do something so boring? Anyway. And yeah, because this is PS2, load times are going to be pretty bad when compared to PC, which are literally non-existent.
Hey, Apu, give me a cola and I need another bucket of ice cream with mini pies.
What happened to the ice cream with mini pies your wife bought this morning?
I probably ate it. I don't remember stuff too good.
Congratulations, Homer. Mission complete. Go back home and talk to Mom to start the next mission.
Oh, Frostilicus gag.
Yeah, freezer burn on my beard.
I forget what episode that was from. It was season 5, I want to say? Silent Alarm, which has appeared a couple times. The, what is this thing? I forget what it's called exactly, but basically the slushy machine. ATM. And Larry the Looter. This is from, I think, season 3. Though I forget what episode exactly. I forget what episode, though. And, oh, hey, what's this over here? Ah, no tutorial. you can change costumes, and in certain parts of the game, I'm gonna have to. So here we have Homer in his underwear throughout the series. Homer in a muumuu from King-Sized Homer when Homer intentionally put on weight so he could work at home. So he didn't have to take part in the Burns exercise program. And the Chosen One from Homer the Great, where Homer joins the Stonecutters. Really nothing to explain there. Now, I could go home and talk to Marge to start the next mission, but I don't want to do that.
Well, I hope do not press means press right away.
Yeah, as you can tell, I've played this game quite a bit before, so I just know where all this stuff is. And I think...
Nobody knows why these things have turned up all over Springfield. They always seem to turn up whenever something exciting happens. I don't know what they are, but violence is always an appropriate response in the face of the unknown.
Cool deal. And yeah, you get, I think it's 26 coins for a wasp camera and 31 out of a box. So... crab juice from the episode where the Simpsons family went to New York and Homer drank a bunch of crab juice and had to go to the bathroom real bad. That was season 8, I want to say. Maybe season... No, I think it was season 8. Although there is a chance it was season 9. Now, I don't think... Unless I either get really unlucky in the missions, or I do really dumb bullshit, I don't think I'm going to fail a single mission. Unless one of those conditions are met. Now, I'm waiting to be proven wrong on this. Alright, is there anything up here? Okay, that's in a later chapter. So, I could talk to Marge to start the next mission, but I want to explore the town. This is the first Simpsons game where you can really explore Springfield like this. Unless you count Road Rage, I guess. But Road Rage is vastly inferior to this game, which I think everyone watching will agree. Oh, and I think there's something over here, isn't there? Or is this in a later chapter, too? My memory's not perfect, mind you. I didn't, like, 100% speedrun this or anything, and... what's that? What are those flags on my radar?
Here's how this works. Milhouse, Nelson, and Ralph run a series of races around town. Complete all the races, and you unlock a new vehicle. Well, what are you waiting for?
What am I waiting for? I'm waiting to challenge myself on these races. Also, I haven't pointed out, but this music. This is the best song in the game right here. Oh. Now, I am going to be... get out of here. I am going to be destroying... I'm going to be getting 100%. So, I'll be doing all the races, showing off all the collector card locations and such. So, yeah. I do like that I can just get up on top of the school roof like this. You just get these coins. So I think... oh, I'm surprised I didn't fall through the crack there. There's another camera here, right? Yes. Okay, cool. Although, if I have to coin grind, which I know I'm gonna have to at parts, I'll just do that off screen. Hey, there's a dice on the radar.
If you need to really put the hammer down and drive, you can always enter these time trial races. They cost a little to enter, but they have a mucho dinero there.
Good deal.
I am excelente.
And needless to say, if you're in your car, you can run the vending machines over and the boxes. And wasps, if you're precise enough. Oh, speaking of boxes. Look at that. I got 400 coins already. I actually did the math on this. You need around 14,000 coins to purchase everything for 100%. So yeah, you're going to be spending a lot of time either coin grinding or... either coin grinding or doing wager races. Which is actually less efficient than a method that has been discovered and is always used for speedruns. And there is no collector card up here this time. There will be later.
I love to sit. I'm a lean, mean speed thingy.
Let's go over to the 939 area code, the rich area. I think these segments are gonna go no more than 30 minutes at a time, roughly. Because... like, if I really wanted to, I could do this whole game in one sitting. But I'm not gonna do that. Ah! Hello, rocket car. Every mission has a random level-specific vehicle placed within the map. And here's the rocket car.
Get a ride from anybody you see on the street. We Simpsons have done a lot for Springfield, so it's okay to get something back.
In other words, I'm gonna carjack people. Whoa, this car is fast. Is it tough? Uh-oh, that's not good. That's not good. It doesn't turn that well either. Oh no!
Wow, you really homerized that car. Don't worry, just sit tight for a few seconds and everything will be as good as new. Why? Who knows? I just read what it tells me.
That car didn't last very long, did it? Obviously, I knew that that car wasn't going to last. At least you can get your coins back once it self-destructs.
Never. Run.
Again.
Let's roll.
So I think I'll end the segment once I finish a whole lap around here just to explore and talk a bit. And I'm not gonna lie, I don't actually remember where the rest of the collector cards are. I remember where at least one of them is, though. I know where two of them are offhand. I don't think there's anything on top of that roof yet. Oh! Okay, I know we're... speaking of Homer the Great, here's the Stonecutter's Tunnel. Can I destroy this? Thank you. Yeah. The depth perception in this is kind of off at times. There are times where you feel you should hit something, but don't. I don't know. It's a little bit weird. But let's grab this collector card, which is the sacred parchment, which Homer used to clean his ears and blow his nose, and he used it as a bib.
Eat my dust.
And that episode had Patrick Stewart as a special voice. Patrick Stewart, of course, being known for being Jean-Luc Picard in Star Trek The Next Generation. Alright, now right here, you can get access to this area in Mission 4, but you can get to here right now. Just kick that open and... hey, here's the human chess board, which was mentioned in one of the newer... well, by newer, I mean like only 10th season. And there's Burns' mansion, which we can't get into yet. We'll get into it later, but for now, this is all we can really do. Chafing! So I know there's one more collector card here, but I'm going to hold off on collecting it because I'll be coming back through here later anyway. And there's a gag in there, but again, holding it off until a more appropriate time to do it. Hey, the Tamako field from season, I want to say 11? Maybe 10? I think it's 11. Ah, the tire fire. Let's jump over it. Oh no, I failed. Luckily, it just respawns you outside the death pit, basically. Oh, there is a... Is there a collector card? Oh yeah, there is. The Mr. Sparkle box is here, I think. Yeah, I was gonna say, I need to zoom out. Okay, so there's one more collector card unaccounted for. But actually, I think I know where that is. Hi, Cletus.
Okay, around town, you'll probably run into a few people I like to call losers. Maybe they need a ride, or maybe they need help. Whatever, the point is, once you've helped them out, they will be available to help drive your lazy butt around.
Sure, let's do it.
Hey, I know you. You're in my dumb guy support group. Mind if I borrow your truck for a while?
No can do, Mr. Fancy Blue Pants. I've begotten to finish up my daily chores, or else Brandine ain't making her muskrat pie tonight.
Fine, I'll help you with your hillbilly chores.
You help me bring in this season's harvest, and I'll take you anywhere you be needing to go. Woohoo! First most, I want you to go to the gas station, get me some of those cardboard tubes, you know them? I'm gonna build me some indoor plumbing. When you finish with that, knock down all them tobacco plants so the youngins can clean them up for market.
I don't think that's going to be a good idea, Cletus, but whatever. I'll do your hillbilly chores for you.
Well, it's about
now, this is only the first bonus mission in the game, and technically the first real mission I'm doing, but this is actually kind of a hard one. Like, you could actually easily fail this one. Now, it is possible to do this in another vehicle called the Duff Truck, which I'll be getting to in a bit. But... You don't really want to be doing it in slow vehicles. Woo-hoo! Oh, and you see that yellow meter that's filling up near my radar. Oh, crap, I activated that too early. Yep, the cops are after me. Let's go!
The important thing is I'm not
now, if this was a casual playthrough, I would not accept getting busted, but here I might not have an option, and I really don't want to waste you guys' time. So if I get busted, I get busted. And this is a really bad place for this, because anytime you hit what the game considers an object, your hit and run meter, we'll call it, goes up. And I just got out of hit and run, and I think we're about to go back into hit and run.
Let's do this thing.
Oh, we just barely avoided it somehow. Don't ask me how. Go! It's time we made it. And we made it. With 40 seconds to spare.
I wish I had a dog with a
just trust me, that one can be hard.
Okay, city boy, I'll help you. You just yell into one of those magic talk boxes, and I come a-running. Oh, man, them things is crazy.
We're number one! We're number one!
If you ever feel like getting a new set of wheels and you're not picky, just talk to old Gil. He's always got a couple crap boxes to sell.
Cool deal. Speaking of Gil, he's right behind me.
Let's see you do better.
Dun 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 dun.
You just gotta help old.
Here it is. The Duff Truck. The slowest vehicle in the game that you can access from the phone booth. Without codes. But we'll check out that pickup truck real quick. I'm not going to use it for much, but...
Chest pain! Having chest pain! Can you come and get me? I'll pay you in back rubs.
Yeah, sir. I need to pick up some cardboard tubes anyways.
Cool deal.
I believe you'd be walking the opposite door.
Now, here's the deal with people driving you around. If you do the bonus mission for that level, whoever's vehicle it belongs to will... Whoever the vehicle belongs to will be driving the vehicle. But there's also another condition for getting NPCs to drive vehicles. Also, I can't make this jump. I already said if you complete the bonus mission, that person will be driving it for that mission. But also, certain missions will have the character driving it. But also, more importantly, if the NPC is not used at any point during the level you're on, then they'll be available. But if they're anywhere on the overworld during that mission, they will not come to drive you around. You'll just be driving their vehicle. Also, this is a little bit precarious here. Come on. Okay. And I missed out on all the coins, but oh well. It's not a big deal. All that matters is that you kill the wasp, which I did.
Must never
run again! Here I said I'm not going to be using the pickup truck for too much, but here I am just using it. Oh. Is there a wasp camera behind here? I actually don't remember offhand. Okay, apparently not. So how many wasp cameras have I destroyed? Oh, I'm missing 6. Ooh. I thought I was missing like 2. Trying to think where those wasps might be. Oh, there's one of them. I did think there was one here. And sometimes you can just talk to NPCs.
My name is Homer.
Mommy says scabs are nature's bandages.
Indeed, Ralphie Wiggum. Everyone's fan favorite. Homer. Thank you. Now, I'm missing all but... I got all but one, but I know where the missing one is, so... And that was a nice little drive around Springfield. But I'm going to make Homer run to the Flanders backyard. And see what's up over here. Or run into the invisible wall. I'm real surprised you can't ring Flanders' doorbell.
Your driving is adequate, but lacks.
Actually, wait, I know where one more wasp is offhand. Oh well. Whatever, I'll find it at some point. So, on this note here,
we only come out to go to church.
I will see you guys next time to start the missions properly.